On the 12th of October 2009, Andrew Hall was suspended as headmaster of Calday Grange Grammar School. Nearly a year on, the school is still without its headmaster, and rumours fly back and forth about whether he will return. It emerged that allegedly the panel for Mr. Hall's disciplinary hearing had been selected by the governing body, the body that suspended Mr. Hall in the first place. A group named the Concerned Calday Parents decided to stage a protest outside of the school, not just for this kangaroo court, but also suggesting it may now be time for the governors to resign.
Right, so we've been told you're the sort of person that sort of rallied and put all this together. Why don't you just tell us a little bit about what you're doing here, what sort of things are going on?
Sure. Well, 12 months ago, parents like myself were very happy to see their kids coming into Calday every morning because it's an outstanding school with an outstanding head teacher. 1 year later, we have a school in turmoil with a head teacher having been out of here for almost a year now. Other senior management affected, other things going on. Parents have been very concerned about the changes that they've seen. They've tried to engage with the governing body, and they haven't agreed to ever talk to us. And we have finally had enough. We have decided that we don't want Calday to have this governing body anymore. So we're protesting largely. But we can see as parents that the governing body have set the school on a wayward path, which we don't fully understand, and they won't explain why, and we're worried about the changes that we see happening.
So you're part of the demonstration.
Yes, that's right.
Do you want to just outline briefly why you're here?
We're here because we've lost absolute confidence in the governing body. They have, apart from a year ago, they suspended the head, and for a school to actually be still a year later without a head is a disgrace. They have ignored any communication that we have asked for. Their behaviour, we think, has been exceptionally irresponsible, and we feel now that there is a witch hunt going on with Mr. Hall. And we've been kept out of the loop, we're very suspicious of what's going on, and we have been reduced to taking this action, which none of us want to do, but this is all we can do now because we've been through every other option available, and it's just got to stop.
So it's got to the stage where you've got so little information and you feel there's so much detriment from the actions of the governors.
We've been ignored, we've sent numerous letters to the governing body, we've had no replies, we've had basically things that weren't true sent to us, and we've been able to verify that this wasn't the case.
Can I just ask you what sort of things?
Well, one of them was a statement about the governing body that we were told we had a letter home to say that this was not a trust status school, and yet it was registered as a trust status school.
You've been within the school as all this has sort of been going on. Can you give us any sort of information or basically your take on what's going on?
It's very difficult to give you any information because as teachers we didn't have any. We knew that Mr. Hall had been suspended and weren't given any further information as to the reasons for that. We didn't have any more information than parents had about the ongoing process, investigation, disciplinary hearings and so on. So really there's not an awful lot I can say except that there's been a lack of information. I completely understand that they can't discuss what allegations might be, but I feel that perhaps the governing body should have made it clear the process they were following, because I believe that, in fact, in terms of their own freedom of information statement, there should be a disciplinary process in place which is publicly accessible, and then that reduces some of the rumour and counter-rumour that...
These guys are saying that the protest at hand is in fact disrupting education. It's actually not having a good effect. It's just being detrimental on the way people are working. Right. So Matt, it's pretty obvious what your standpoint's all about. Why don't you just tell us a bit about the stance you're taking on all of this?
I think it's just half the people out there, A, don't know what they're talking about, B, are being massively counterproductive in the sense that half of the people that they're filming or half the people they're protesting against are their kids and they're disrupting them. And if you'd seen an hour before, the fights and the riots that were going on was just all to do with them and completely not what this school needs at all. And it's going to bring such bad publicity because the Northwesternite people that were here is not going to be good publicity for the school. It's just going to make them look like a total.
Oh, we can edit that up.
That was the best word I could think of.
All right. Well, just to clarify, do you have any particular stance on the issue regarding Mr. Hall at all?
That's fine. You can let Mr. Hall. Well, you can if he was ever freed or released of the charges, the accusations that he was. I don't think he'd ever come back anyway. So I think it's completely 100% pointless one.
Really well, you know. We've done it on a Monday lunchtime with parents, many parents working and many who couldn't come here, but we've had a fantastic turnout and I'm really delighted about that. I can't tell you whether we've achieved our aims, time will tell, but we've made it clear that the parents of kids at Calday have had enough and we want it to change as quickly as possible.
This is therefore, you know, one step closer to achieving that.
Well, hopefully the message has got through. If it hasn't, we will have to transmit the message again.
People have turned up here to say is that what is happening is being detrimental to the school itself, and they feel that what is happening is it's having a negative impact, a very negative impact on the school's ability to do its job. And as parents, they're the they're obviously going to be the first people to say that. So I don't know. Maybe the action itself is justified, but you can't dispute what some of the students were saying. I think the ideals are right. The question is, was the method that they employed right?
Made it clear now that I've always been a smiler. Tell me, how did it come to?